deals with the use of stoichiometry and solving for how the concentration changes as a function of the number of moles in a gas phase reaction, so this is key, in which we have a loss in the total number of moles occurring with the reaction. So we have 3 moles on the left-hand side going to 1 mole on the right-hand side, and it turns out, as we'll see, that this can affect our volumetric flow rate through the reactor and thus our concentration. All right, so we want to be able to account for that, and we'll follow the procedure that is outlined by Fogler, and Fogler has some particular notation that we'll use, but of course the general philosophy behind how to solve this problem is important regardless of the text, just that the variables are called particular things by Fogler. And so I've written down some of the given information here. So we're told that the conversion is 75%. We're given temperature and pressure, and we're told that the temperature doesn't change in this problem because it's isothermal. And we'll also assume that the process pressure doesn't change with the reaction. What we want to solve is the outlet concentration. I've assumed a 10 mole basis for the feed, and based on the given compositions of 60% and 40%, we end up with 6 moles of B and 4 moles of A in the feed. All right, the first thing we need to do is we're told that the conversion is 75% for our limiting reactant. So the question is, what is the limiting reactant? Well, we can actually see just by a quick thought experiment that it has to be A, that if we consume all 4 moles of A, so we consume 4 moles of A, we've got this 2-to-1 stoichiometry. And so only 2 moles of B will be consumed, and we'll therefore have 4 left over. So that means we'll have B left over when we consumed all of the A, and therefore A is the limiting reactant. Okay, so we want to use that to find out the concentration of A. The concentration of A is just equal to the molar flow rate of A divided by the volumetric flow rate of the total stream. We can express the molar flow rate in terms of our given variable, the conversion. So FA is just equal to FA naught times 1 minus x, based on the definition of conversion. And we're going to divide that by the volumetric flow rate, which we don't know. Okay, the volumetric flow rate is equal to the total molar flow rate times RT over P by the ideal gas law, since we're told that ideal gas conditions apply. And then we'll do a little trick here to simplify the algebra, and we'll also write that the volumetric flow rate of the inlet stream can be expressed based on the inlet properties. And the reason we'll do this is we'll take a ratio, and that will end up making our life a little bit easier. So we'll divide the first expression by the second one, and then multiply through by V naught. So then we get that V is equal to the inlet volumetric flow rate. And so we'll be able to see how the volumetric flow rate at any given conversion is a function of the volumetric flow rate of the outlet. And if we take that ratio, we get FT over FT naught times T over T naught times P naught over P. All right, and as I mentioned, in future sections of the text, we'll learn how to deal with pressure drop, for example, in a packed bed reactor, and we'll have an expression for P over P naught. But for now, we're going to assume that that goes to 1, that there's no change. We'll end up developing expressions for T as a function of T naught when we do energy balances. But for now, we're going to assume that that goes to 1. And so we only have to deal for today with this FT over FT naught ratio. How are we going to end up doing that? We have, in this case, okay, this reaction of 2A plus B goes to C, and this is a decrease in number of moles from 3 moles written here to 1 mole on this side. And I've written out a couple of facts here, so that for every 2 moles of A that react on this side of the expression, we lose 2 moles of total stuff in our reactor, okay, because we only have A, B, and C in our reactor. All right, so we lose 2 moles of stuff. For every mole of A that reacts, therefore, we lose 1 total mole of stuff in our reactor. Right, and therefore, FT, if we're keeping track of this total number of moles that we need to know, that's equal to the number of moles that we start with times the change in the total molar flow rate as a function of the A that reacts, as a function of the fact that we have a reaction in this case. And so we can track the reaction in terms of the number of moles of A that react, and that's equal to FA naught times X. And then what we need to multiply that by, because we're interested in the total number of moles, the change in the total number of moles, and this is just the change in A, is the ratio of, in the denominator, the moles of A that react to the moles in the numerator, the total moles, the total change in number of moles as a result of that reaction of A. And so for every 2 moles of A that react, we lose 2 total moles of stuff in this reaction. Okay? And we have a negative here because we're losing moles, and we expect the total molar flow rate to decrease from the initial value of FT naught as the reaction proceeds. All right, so we have this negative sign, and it ends up being a negative 1. So if we now take the step of dividing through the dividing this expression through by FT naught, because we see that it's going to be useful to have this ratio here, all right, then we can get this expression that FT over FT naught is equal to 1 plus FA naught over FT naught, which is just the mole fraction of A in the feed, YA naught, times the conversion X, times this variable that Fogler calls delta A, which is the change in the number of moles in the reaction expression, divided by the stoichiometric coefficient of the component that you're tracking, which for us is A. Okay, and so now we can plug in numbers for all this. We actually have all the numbers. And so I've just rewritten it here in terms of YA naught delta A times X, so collected terms. Plugged in our numbers of 40% for YA naught. Based on a 10-mole basis, we have 4 moles of A, so 40%. This negative 1 for our delta A value. And we're told in the problem statement we have a conversion of 75%. And so when you plug in all those numbers and do the simple algebra, we see that the volumetric flow rate is equal to 0.7 times the initial volumetric flow rate. And so we get a 30% drop in the volumetric flow rate because we're losing moles in this reaction at constant temperature and pressure. Now we have the expression for V in terms of V naught, right, that we needed right here. Right, and so we can plug in right here for V in terms of V naught. And so that will just give us that what we need is FA naught over V naught times 0.7. We just solve for times 1 minus x, and we know the value of x. All right, so next what we're going to solve for, this value is equal to CA naught. I'm just going to go ahead and solve for the volumetric flow rate and show how this can work out. And so if we do that on another page that I've already written up, right, we're again using the ideal gas law. So the volumetric flow rate is equal to this RT naught, FT naught over P naught, so R, the gas constant, times the temperature, times the total molar flow rate over the pressure. I can just use this value of the gas constant in terms of atmospheres, liters, moles, and Kelvin. Temperature and pressure are given in the problem statement. I'm just going to let the FT naught float for a minute. Here is our expression for CA now. It's just recopied off the other page where X is equal to 0.75. All right, we now have an expression for V naught that's equal to all this stuff, so we just plug it all in so that we can do the necessary algebra. When we do that, we get this term FA naught over FT naught, which again is YA naught, which is the inlet mole fraction of A. It's 40%, 0.4. And now we have everything that we need in terms of the constants that we've already filtered in at a conversion of 75%. And when I plug in all those numbers, I get an outlet concentration of 0.028 moles per liter. Okay, so the algebra in this problem is fairly straightforward, but again, what I hope that this summarizes is what these YA naught and delta terms really come from. And what you're really doing here is you're keeping track of how the total molar flow rate changes, how the total molar flow rate changes as a result of the reaction of the limiting reactant A. All right, and so when 2 moles of A react, we lose 2 moles of total stuff, and so that gives us this negative 1, and we're ratioing this, and so that's where the delta A comes from, and we're determining this based on the moles of A that react, but what we're interested in is the total moles, and that's where the YA naught comes from. You really don't have to use this kind of notation, so as a shortcut in a lot of problems, we'll use this YA naught and delta A notation. As Fogler does, but you can see that you can arrive at it pretty quickly from a simple mole balance following the stoichiometry of the reaction rate expression.